Hello, people. Staying Dad here. And here to talk about, it's the morning after UFC 205. And I batted about 800 last night. All my predictions were correct. Like to talk about the fights a little bit. First, let's talk about the two Polish girls, JoJo and Carolina. I thought JoJo was actually going to beat her up a little bit better than she did. Her face actually looked a little worse than Carolina's at the very end. Carolina, man, she's a tough girl. Took a lot of abuse. Hung in there to the very end. But I was right, I predicted it. JoJo came out with the win. Now, Wonder Boy and Tyron, that was a pretty good fight. I don't know why Wonder Boy was holding back so much. He wouldn't let his hands or his legs fly as much as he could have. Tyron was good when he was being aggressive. I can't believe Wonder Boy held on in, what was that, the third or the fourth round? When Tyron had him in the guillotine choke. Man, that was amazing. It was an exciting fight, but I still think both fighters could have been a little bit more aggressive. They did a lot of standing, a lot of waiting. When Wonderboy had Tyron back against the cage, I don't know what he was waiting for. You know, he should have let the legs fly, let the hands fly a little bit better. Probably could have come out and won that fight. I agree with the judge's decision that Tyron should have won, but I'm not so sure about the draw. I'm thinking Tyron might have won it at least by 1 point on all the cards. But I'm not a professional judge. It was a pretty good fight, though, considering. And, well, anyway, if they call it a draw and Tyron keeps the belt, does that mean he kind of won the fight still? So my prediction was right. No, my prediction was wrong. I said Wonder Boy was going to win that fight and possibly knock him out. Okay, so I was wrong on that one. Okay, that's right. I called Wonder Boy for the win. All right, I was wrong there. So there you have it. I admit it. I was wrong. A little partial to the karate guy, but he just didn't let his skills fly. And that's why he didn't win. Okay, now let's talk about Eddie Alvarez and Conor McGregor. I called Conor McGregor to win, but I hoped Eddie was going to win the fight, only because I felt it would have made the whole game more interesting to see what Conor would have done next, you know? But I don't know where these analysts and these people that talk up Eddie Alvarez were saying that his boxing skills were so great and his wrestling skills and everything else, because the truth is, Conor beat him with just plain good old fundamental boxing. Granted, Conor's great at what he does. You know, he's a great athlete. He's fit. He's trained in every aspect of the sport. But he's been winning all his fights with just good fundamental boxing. Eddie Alvarez, go back and watch the fight. Go back and watch the fight again. Every time Eddie was throwing a right hand, he was never setting it up with a left. He was coming up short. He'd miss with the right. His shoulder would be facing Connor's left hand with his head. Huge target for Conor just to hit. Every time Eddie threw a right hand that was never set up by a left, his shoulder would be to the back of Conor's left, and Conor was hitting him in the chin every time with the left. Now, Conor's southpaw, so his left is like a big right hand, you know? His left hand is like a big right, and Eddie kept turning his back to him by missing with his right hand, leaving Conor's big left just to come over the back of Eddie's right shoulder and hit him right in the face every time. And Eddie never set up his right with a left. He just, from nowhere, he was just throwing that right out there, missing it, with no strategy, no target in mind, and he was leaving himself wide open for Conor to hit him in the chin every time with that left hand. Conor, just a great counter fighter, And he's been beating everybody with good, strong, fundamental boxing. He's a great boxer. He's got the best boxing hands in MMA. And shame on all these other UFC fighters that say they have boxing skills. You know, I don't get it, man. I don't get it. They can punch 1-2, 1-2, and throw rights and lefts, but they don't set it up with good boxing strategy. Go back, watch the fight. Tell me if I'm wrong. Leave a comment in the bottom if I'm wrong. Go ahead, tell me I'm wrong. I'm not truly an expert. I'm a pretty good observer. You know, I've practiced a little boxing, a lot of karate back in the day when I was a young guy, and I enjoy watching fights, you know. But, you know, good for Connor. You know what? He makes it so simple. You know, he's just doing simple, fundamental, strong fundamentals, and he's whipping these guys. He's just whipping these guys, man. These guys, they can't see the game as clearly as Connor does. And I'm quoting Connor. I saw an interview one time when he was talking about, you know, I just see so clearly. I can see so clearly what everyone's doing and what I need to do to go in there and win fights. And where everybody's making a really complex thing out of it, you know, Connor just sees real clear, sticks to simple, simple, strong, fundamental boxing, and he's whipping these guys. All right. If you like or agree with what I say, you know, go ahead and like this video. Leave a comment on the bottom. You know, feel free to set me straight if I'm wrong about anything. It's all good. But out of all my predictions, I guess I was wrong on one of them. Oh, a note here. When I was watching, what's her name? The girl fight. The one that retired afterwards. Misha Tate. You know, halfway through that fight, I was commenting to my nephew and some family that was over here. We were getting back, drinking some beers and watching the fight. I commented that Misha Tate should just retire after this bout because, man, she just was not putting on a good performance whatsoever. Sure enough, after the fight, when she lost, she announced her retirement. So, that was a pretty good call. Anyhow, everyone have a good day. 205 was a success, I guess. It was pretty interesting. And Connor's just going to keep beating everybody else up with his strong fundamental boxing that all these other mixed martial artists just don't have. They like to swing big haymakers, you know, and they don't set up their punches proper. They don't counter proper. They're just in there brawling and fists are flying. And that's why Connor is so good at his percentage of landed strikes. Because he doesn't waste any energy. He picks his shots. And, you know, he just doesn't waste any punches. You know, and that's what a good boxer does. All right. Everyone have a nice day. Till next time. Ciao.